chill, Nabi, chill. Thank you.
So you might ask me, what's this? Tangle remover, not necessary right now for removing the tangle, but I apply this to make his hair more smooth. So in the future, he will have less tangle. Tangle, right? Tangle means knot, you know, because miniature schnauzer, they have curly hair, and if they have too much dirt or they have some plants or leaves or seeds or branches in his hair, the thing will get stuck all together and it's really hard to remove. For long term, it's not gonna good for his comfort. So yeah, and I'm gonna just make that thing absorb into his hair, so in the future it's easier for me to brush. Like this, sometimes when he was younger, he do not like to be air blowed, and now he's okay. And for me, for training, one most important part is whenever he does something good, I do it because he did something good as the result, because he did something good, so that reinforcement can make them, you know, always has good habit. Right now I'm gonna brush a little bit, so to increase the surface area so that it's easier to dry. Physics, Nabi. And the favorite part that I like about Nabi is that when he was younger, I always kind of like squish him, you know, a little bit. So make him to get used to a little bit of pain. So when I use those kind of brushes or my kids play with him, he's okay. He's not like, you know, aggressive because someone pinched him or anything like that, because he has always been cheating like that. And if one day he became a therapy dog, you know, which is our goal, and he can serve other kids. His feet is a little bit sensitive. His paw a little bit sensitive. And something that you need to know, every time after a shower, his hair is more tangled together because the water. So when you brush them, they are a little bit more sensitive rather than dry hair. Because if there's something stuck inside, the hair will literally get together. I wish I can show you something, but I just brushed him before the shower, so cannot find a lot. Abby, get up. Stay. Goodbye. Stay. Turn around for me. Thank you. Back is almost dry, so right now I'm gonna do on the belly. Yeah, It's all good. Stay. Good boy. When you don't move, I give you a treat as a reward, because that will make you like shower, like being brushed, like laying on my leg. Be a good puppy. And maybe gain some weight like me. Remember before I was talking about knots? So for example here, I hope you can see that. So in this part, this area, you can tell it's not straight hair, and some hair that just cross each other, I will consider that as a knot, and later on you want to clean them to make sure there are not extra dead or old hair around here. So for example this one, you see that? Pinching up here, this one's old hair, and that's the point when you brush them, because they don't shed, so you have to brush that off to keep him comfortable, because if you don't brush miniature schnauzer, eventually they're gonna look like homeless dog, like classic homeless dog. Right, so stay. Hey. Just brush a little bit. I'll use compi instead. I think that one, the needle-ish thing is too sharp, and you might make you feel uncomfortable. Daddy's little girl, Nabi. You have so much hair. It's okay. So later on I have to cut his nail and groom for him. That will take me another 1 or 2 hours, because groom take just generally longer time. Hey, stay. And in general, when I froze, he would have froze too, because in general training, when I froze, it means he has to look at me, look at my eyeballs, and check my eyes and get some food. The condition of him getting food is stare into my eyes, wait patiently, be very polite, and then he can have his food. by me. I give him food actively. Yeah. And there are other conditions for him to get food too. For example, when he did something good, you know, when he sits down or when he plays with other dogs, he's really well behaved. I'll give him treat myself. I always try to find those good opportunities to reward him to get food, rather than doing some specific training. And into training, I like to merge that into his daily life. I remember when he was younger, I usually take him to a university squad and just train him there with his kibbles, because he has to eat anyway. Instead of like using a specific training time, I'd rather, you know, doing the in the meal time. Yeah, it's okay. Come on.
Here.